Hello friends, welcome to freeprojects.com, and this is my new project called as Event Management System, and I have developed this project in Java, JSP, and backend I have used MySQL, and currently I am using the MySQL version 5.6 for running this project, and for connecting the database from the JSP and Java, I have used the MySQL J connector. The version is 5.9. So you can easily connect your MySQL database using the Java and JSP from the MySQL connector 5.9 or 5.10. And for front-end designing, I have used HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Also, I have used some of the jQuery plugins for creating some good effects in the website. So you can see this is a slider. So this slider is moving on. And this slider I have created using the jQuery, and I am using the jQuery version 1.10. And for validation part, I have also used the jQuery for validating the forms. So you will not be able to submit any of the forms without filling it. So this type of validation is available in this website, in this project. Okay, so the project name is College Event Management System. So main focus and purpose for developing this project is to managing all of the events of the college. So there might be any number of events in the college. It might be a seminar, it might be a job fair, it might be a freshers party, and it might be anything. So if from this project, the student and faculty will be able to manage those events. Okay, so let's start with the project, and let's explore the functionality, that what the functionalities are available in the project. So let's go one by one. So this is the home page of the project. So the second one is the about us and about the event management system, and second one and the third one is the all events. So these are the events which is available in this project. So you can create n number of events in the project. If you want to see the events or program details, just click on the programs, view programs. All the programs will be listed here, but unfortunately there is a single here program. So suppose if there is an event, then there will be a number of programs in that event. So you can add in any number of programs in that event and their times. So the event name and the program name and the what is the start time and what is the end time, right? So all the programs will be, so there are three programs in this event. So all the events must have the program. So you can add event, and after that you can add programs in that event. So next is the student log. One more thing. So if student want to register on the events, just for that, the student will log into the system, and after that he will be able to register on the event. And if student is not doesn't have their login credential, then he will be able to register on the website and create their user ID and password, and then register on that event, right? So this is the student login, from where student will be able to log in, and this is the admin login, where admin will be able to log in. So there are two types of roles in this project. First one is the student, and second one is the admin. Admin will be able to do anything in the project. So he will be able to manage the events, programs, each and everything. But the student will be able to register on the website, and second is to attend the event. And this is the register. So this is the student registration form, where student will enter his all details, his or her all details, and he will be able to register and create their credentials. And this is the contact us. So this is the very static form. So I am not saving the details of this contact us form in the database. So let's start. Also, there is some five menus here in the top, so you can see the all menus are working. So let's start with the admin functionality. So this is the admin functionality. So once you log in with the admin, then you will be able to see all of the modules which can be performed by the admin. So this is the dashboard of the admin. So you can see these all actions the admin can perform, right? So the all the actions which is available here is also available in the menu part. So there is a home, and there is a dashboard, and there is a administrator add event. So this is the add event. So admin will be able to add the events. So admin will be able to enter the event details and save that event details here. And after that, event themes. So what is the event theme? So it might be a seminar, it might be a freshers party, it might be anything. So admin will be able to add any number of themes here, and that event theme will be associated to that event. So if you click on the add event, then this is the add event, add theme. So this is the games, workshops, seminars, or annual functions. So this is the totally dynamic drop down. The all the events theme which is added in the database will be displayed here, right? So next one is a add event theme. Second is the add services. So these are the event services. So these event services are these. So you can see that what type of services is needed for the that event. So that services will be displayed here. So all the services which has been added into the database will be displayed here. So this section is also a dynamic section, right? So next one is the add event program. So in that he will be able to add any number of programs in that event. So this is the add event select event. So you will choose the event, and after that you will be able to add the programs in that event. And then after that you can choose the program type, that what type of program is that, right? The second one is the add users. So this is the admin user. So admin will be able to add any number of users here. So he will be, if admin creates any user, then admin will that user will be able to perform all the operations of that admin also, right? So this is the report sections. So you can see that this is the report, and if admin wants to edit it, then just click on the edit and save the event. So that event functionality will be saved, and after that if the admin want to view the program of that event, then he will be able to view the programs from here also. So this is the event report where admin will be able to see the reports and update it, and then service reports. So again edit and update the service, and then the event program reports. So what the programs are there, and same the CRUD application and the student reports, and then the user reports. And after that there is a my account section, the admin my account section, and the change password, and then after that logout. Once admins gets logged out, then admin and none of the internal functionality will be accessed by anyone, right? So let's start with the student login. So I am logging with Amit and test. So this is the student dashboard where a student will be able to see all of the events. So this is the all events. So you can see that event reports which is displayed in the admin section is different, and this is the all different. This is that all events report, right? So for in this event, a student that Amit has not been registered, and once he clicks on the register, then the registration has been made, and this okay, your registration has been made. Now you can cancel the registration, and this. So I have registered for this event, these three events, and not for those two events. So for these three events, there is a cancel registration button, and for those two events for which I have not registered, there is a register for event type. And then after that, this is a my account section where a student will be able to update their my account section, and then contact us, and then logout. Okay, so this is the project which I have developed for managing the college event management system. And if you need any of the extra functionality in this project, then don't forget to post into the comments. Sure, I will add those functionality in my project. And don't forget to subscribe our channel freeprojects.com to get a daily video updates of the latest project topics. Thanks for watching the video.